Assalamu alaikum and warm welcome from the World Bank IMF annual meetings here in the beautiful city of Marrakech, Morocco. I'm Hatim Al-Othmani and we are back at the Digital Zone where we are unpacking the vital conversation happening right here. It's my privilege to introduce Kibuc Asfaw, co-founder and CEO of Kubic. Kibuc, welcome to the Digital Zone.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks for joining us. Kibuc, if it's possible to introduce Kubic to our viewers.
So Kubic is an environmental technology company. Our mission is to build dignity through clean and affordable living for all. Mm-hmm. How we do this is by recycling hard-to-recycle plastic waste and converting it into low-carbon and low-cost building materials. Mm-hmm. Because one of the biggest priorities that municipalities have all over the world is to reduce waste, increase the affordability of housing, mm-hmm. all while being able to be a solution in climate change.
Absolutely. And by the way, while browsing Kubic's website, it highlights a striking stats that is by 2030, 300 million families will need a dignified place to live in. Your company turns hard-to-recycle plastic waste into affordable, low-carbon buildings. How does this contribute to addressing the housing challenge?
So the statistic is even a lot more alarming. We're seeing the gap between the need and mm-hmm. the supply of affordable housing growing every day. Mm-hmm. Just in sub-Saharan Africa, over 100 million housing units are actually needed. Mm-hmm. And one of the critical issues right now is that real estate developers, who are the linchpin for making this happen, don't see the business proposition to actually engage in affordable housing projects because mm-hmm. materials are very expensive. What we do is make them our client mm-hmm. and give them anywhere from 30 to 50% discount on these building materials that they're used to, also that they're incentivized to address this massive problem all over the world.
Indeed. And in Ethiopia, by the way, as in many other countries in Africa, plastic is typically handled by waste pickers, many of whom still live in extreme poverty. Could you talk about how your company is working with them and what you think is needed to create a more dignified place of work for them?
Waste management is a very critical infrastructure for any country. And waste pickers are probably the most critical workforce to making mm-hmm. this happen. Unfortunately, this sector has huge disparities between who is picking the waste and mm-hmm. who's actually selling it. Mm-hmm. What we do is have a direct-to-collector supply strategy. What mm-hmm. this means is we buy directly from waste pickers. Mm-hmm. This does several things. Mm-hmm. It helps us nurture a much stronger infrastructure within waste management, but more importantly, it provides economic empowerment to women because over 80% of waste pickers happen to be women. Mm-hmm. They're the most underrepresented and marginalized, mm-hmm. and we have an opportunity to make them mm-hmm. a lot more successful in this very critical sector.
That's impressive. And speaking about poverty as well, as you know, the World Bank has unveiled its renewed mission to end extreme poverty and boost shared prosperity on a livable planet. What does that mean to you?
It's probably rephrased differently than our mission, but we need a livable planet. And mm-hmm. that comes down to people having the opportunity and choice mm-hmm. of how and where they live. Mm-hmm. The way that we do this is by driving the affordability around housing, mm-hmm. solid infrastructure that people can call their own, mm-hmm. but at the same time, having an environment mm-hmm. where it's clean, mm-hmm. It's not polluted, mm-hmm. and obviously it's rid of any of the challenges that climate change has brought to them. Mm-hmm. The more that we scale as a business, we are reducing plastic waste, mm-hmm. we are making very beautiful homes, a lot more affordable to everyone, mm-hmm. all while making the most polluting sector, which is real estate, less polluting over time. We need to decarbonize cities. Mm-hmm. And it's once we do that, that this massive issue around climate change could also be addressed.
Absolutely. And that's really impressive. And I'm very optimistic on your mission as well. And thank you so much again for your presence here and your participation, but also sharing with us your highly valuable insights. And thank you again for joining the Digital Zone of the World Bank.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you.